Malacanang says President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s state visit to Malaysia advanced the finalization of a collaboration agreement between Metro Pacific Investment Corporation and rail services firm Hartasuma. According to the palace, a deal could yield up to 3 billion pesos in rail-oriented projects. Meanwhile, AirAsia also pledging to invest $1 billion to expand its operations in the Philippines. AirAsia CEO Tony Fernandez signed a letter of intent during Marcos's trip, specifically on aviation maintenance, repair and overhaul operations, and logistics operations. These deals are on top of the $285 million in investment pledges Marcos earlier announced.
Here are some local corporate headlines. PLDT's ICT subsidiary partners with cybersecurity firm Palo Alto Networks for end-to-end cloud security coverage. EPLDT President and CEO Victor Genuino says the partnership allows them to keep customers protected as they migrate to cloud or hybrid environments. PLDT shares joined the market downswing, closing lower by 0.6% in Friday trade. Meanwhile, Ayala Malls confirms it is seeking approval for its redevelopment plan for Greenbelt 1. It says the redevelopment is necessary to meet the changing needs of its customers. Dennis Oy's PH Resorts Group, currently in final stages of talks with foreign and local investor to help it complete and launch its flagship Emerald Bay Integrated Resort. The Cebu project was put to a pause after its partnership with tycoon Enrique Razon fell through. The company shares closed flat in today's trade. Meanwhile, the Securities and Exchange Commission approves ASEN shelf registration that covers up to 50 billion pesos of preferred shares. ASEN says up to 12.5 billion pesos in preferred shares will be offered in the first tranche. The offer period will open on August 11. ASEN shares plunge almost 4% in today's trade. And finally, Cebu Pacific hikes aircraft deliveries to a record 21 this year. This is higher than the expected 15 deliveries. The budget carrier says 17 of the aircraft are fuel-efficient Airbus Neos as it aims to shift to a more sustainable fleet by 2028. Cebpac shares slipped 0.1% in today's trade.
Here's how European markets are doing on the last trading day of the week. They are showing a mixed picture after Germany, the region's biggest economy, failed to show any growth in the second quarter. Analysts had expected the country to eke out a 0.1% increase in GDP following a mild recession. The data pointing to renewed weakness ahead for the Eurozone. As for Wall Street, futures are pointing to a positive open with the Nasdaq leading the rally. This is after Intel reported a surprise return to profitability following two quarters of losses. Intel shares are up more than 6% in pre-market trade. Investors also watching out for data on personal spending and consumer sentiment.
Here in Asia, the big week of interest rate decisions closed out with the Bank of Japan delivering a surprise policy adjustment. While it kept its key rates at ultra-low levels, the BOJ loosened its grip on its yield curve control, which means allowing long-term interest rates to rise beyond its 0.5% cap. BOJ Governor Kazuo Iuda says making its yield curve control more flexible would increase the sustainability of the bank's monetary easing as it brings inflation to its 2% target. The move sent Japanese bond yields soaring to 9-year highs while the yen rallied. Japan's Nikkei 225, on the other hand, slid as much as 2.44% before pairing those losses. Australia's ASX 200 also slipped after retail sales there fell in June. Here at home, Philippine shares joined decliners with the main index posting its first weekly loss in 3 weeks.
As the market further digests the Fed rate hike and also some statements from Fed Chair Powell. And if we would look at the PSEI's RSI is also already approaching that 70 level. So I think some may have locked in their profits by selling up their positions. And yes, it's the movement earlier. I mean, it's still part of that sideways movement that we are seeing in the coming weeks.